Good morning.
Good morning.
Good morning, sir.
Good morning, sir.
Good morning. Good morning.
Sir, आज तो हमने वो difficult part करेंगे ना variable variable master.
No, no.
Okay.
We introduced impulses, right? We have to solve a few problems on impulses.
Okay, sir.
No, listen. This string is of length L and the mass is M. The string is of length L and mass M. If I take this mass to the horizontal position and release it, what will be the velocity when it comes to the lowermost point?
Root 2gl.
Under root 2gl, right?
Yes, sir.
Anybody was a doubt in it?
No, sir.
No, sir.
But suppose I bring it till here and bring it a bit closer. This distance is L root 3 by 2. And I release the mass from here. I didn't release from here. In this position, the string was taut.
Yes.
Now I released from here. What will be the velocity when it comes to the lowermost point? Is the question clear?
Yes.
The difference between the two situations is, in one situation, I'm taking, this is the point where I'm taking this way and releasing. In the other situation, I brought it a bit closer and released it. Right? The hint is, from this position, when it falls straight till here, the string is not taut. Here, yes. The string will become taut and that will be an impulsive force.
Yes, sir.
Right? That's a hint. I'll wait for you.
Yes, sir.
What do we need to find?
Velocity of the bob when it comes to the lowermost point.
So can you please repeat the hint?
No.
Okay.
So 3 minutes.
Sir, can you please repeat the question? I just joined.
People who have just joined, switch on your mics, catch your ears, take 2 sit-ups, I'll repeat the question. Switch on your camera. Catch your ears. Are 9:45 ka class, cheating karke aap logon ne 10 baje shuru karwaya. Wo bhi chalega mere. No problem.
Light chali gayi thi, sir. Sir, light chali
gayi. Sir, wo sahi bol raha hai. Idhar lights gayi hai. इधर लाइट्स के मेरा भी कैमरा नेट से
मैसेज गया।
कौन से एरिया?
सर अनुशक्ति नगर सर।
नवी मुंबई सर, नवी मुंबई में लाइट गई।
ओके। फाइन, आई विल बिलीव यू। लिसन। क्वेश्चन आस्क्ड इज दिस बॉल इफ इट इज टेकन टू द राइट मोस्ट पॉइंट एंड रिलीज्ड व्हेन इट कम्स डाउन द वेलोसिटी विल बी अंडर रूट 2gl. But here what we did is we brought it a bit closer. The distance is L root 3 by 2 and you released from here. When it comes down straight from here till here, the string will not be taut. Here all of a sudden the string will become taut, which will be an impulsive force. Right? They're asking you, if they brought the bob closer and released, find the velocity when it comes to the lowermost point. Is the question clear?
Yes, sir.
It will not be under root 2gl. Utna to be clear. from here till here, the string is not taut. And at this point, the string will become taut.
Yes.
Right? So, can I calculate this height? This is L. This is L root 3 by 2. How much will this angle be?
30 degrees.
That means this will be 60 degrees. Do you agree with that?
Yes, sir.
Yes.
So how much will this height be?
L by 2.
So what will be from here till here? The bob is falling under the influence of gravity. It is a free fall. So what will be the velocity here? I'll call it u. Under root 2g L by 2. Under root gl. Now the beauty in the problem is there is an impulsive force P delta T
tension
comes into life at this particular instant. P delta T is the change in momentum. How much will T delta T be out of academic interest? Right? If this is 60, this will be 60. This will be under root GL cos 60.
Root GL by 2.
Right? This is the initial velocity just before the string becomes taut.
Yes.
Just after the string becomes taut, what will be the velocity along the length of the string? This side of the string is fixed. Two ends of the string, zero.
Zero, no?
This is U initial. U final along the length of the string will be zero. This end is fixed. This end also will not move along the length of the string.
Yes, sir. It will have a horizontal.
Right? What is the change in momentum will be equal to T delta T. T delta T will be the change in momentum. If you ask me how much is the impulse due to the string, final momentum minus initial momentum. T delta T. Should I put a negative sign because that is in this direction? While m into final momentum is 0 minus initial momentum is m into under root gl by 2. This negative negative taken, t delta t is the impulse in the string, m into under root gl by 2. This was not asked. I have just calculated for you to understand the value of impulsive force. How much is T delta T? So much is the impulsive force. Along the length of the string, just before the string became taut, velocity just before the string became taut, just after the string became taut. Is this point clear?
Yes, sir.
Yes.
Yes.
Now, in the question, this was not asked. What was asked? This velocity will survive. Why will this velocity survive here? It is perpendicular to the impulse.
Yes.
Right. This will be under root GL sine 60. So after the string became taut, what is the kinetic energy of the bob? Half M under root GL into root 3 by 2. Right? Whole square?
Yes.
This is the kinetic energy of the bob after the string became taut. This kinetic energy is destroyed by this impulsive force. The velocity became zero after the string became taut. So this kinetic energy survived plus this potential energy mgl into 1 minus cos 60 should be equal to half m v naught square. I'll call this v. Can you calculate v naught from here?
Yes.
You understood the significance of the impulsive force here. This T delta T destroyed the velocity component along the length of the string. If ever they ask you the value of this impulse, this is the way you calculate T delta T. Do take directions into consideration. Final momentum, initial momentum is in this direction. T delta T is in the opposite direction.
Sir, V naught is under root 7 GL by 2, right?
If the answer kya hai, tell me, that will be the answer. I don't have the answer, we'll go with common consensus. Others do the simplification.
sir. Sir, I'm not able to understand, sir, how that T delta T is getting destroyed by root GL cos 60, sir.
T delta
T. बोल दिया अरे रे
पैर पैर ऊपर सर नीचे लटका दो T delta T is not getting destroyed. It is coming into life. यहां से यहां तक there was no tension in the string. It was born at this particular moment. पैदा होते ही तूने उसे मार दिया यार. T delta T is the impulse in this direction. This is the initial momentum. This is the final momentum.
Sir, sir, how is the final momentum zero then?
अरे सर
क्या along the direction tension के वजह से वो cancel out हो जाता है.
Length of a string, constraints we learned when we were born. If this velocity here is zero, what will be the velocity along the length of the string here?
Zero.
अब क्यों नहीं बोल रहे हो बंदा? हम क्या है इसका?
Sherwin.
Sherwin.
Sherwin. नहीं है क्या? Obviously. Right? Now this and this will have the same velocity along the length of the string. Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
So if this is zero, what will the velocity here be?
Zero.
Zero, sir. Both are.
The momentum is?
Zero.
T delta T changed that momentum. Who changed this momentum? Which force? This impulsive force.
Yes.
Sir, why did we take minus T delta T?
Directions, momentum and forces are vectors.
Chaha, ultra direction.
In which direction they flow, this is in which direction they flow, this is in which direction.
Yes,
momentum
sir, yes.
is in this direction. T delta T is in opposite direction.
Yes, sir, understood.
So, what is the final value of V0?
I don't know the
root
answer.
7 GL by
2. How much again? Under root 7
GL by 4.
4 is inside.
4 under.
Inside.
By 2 ho jaya. Okay.
Ah, all of you know the root 4 is 2. Very good. I'm happy.
Sir, COVID batch achievement.
हाँ दिख रहा है
हाँ सर हॉल ऑफ फेम में डाल देते हैं
उसी की कमी है हॉल ऑफ फेम
Dance.
Next problem is slightly tricky, but you will have to get accustomed to this terminology here also. So The question asked is like this. This is a ball of mass m. This is of length l. This is a heavy platform fixed at this height. This is a heavy platform fixed at this height, such that height h is lesser than l. H is lesser than L. That means for sure small m will collide with the platform.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Small m will collide with the platform.
Yes.
Collision between small m and platform is perfectly inelastic. Collision between small m and platform is perfectly inelastic. Perfectly inelastic. Find the height to which small m rises after the collision. This is a smooth platform. Smooth. Find the height to which small m rises after the collision. Write down the statement. Find the height to which small m rises after the collision.
बड़ा अजीब लगेगा
इन्हें यार. प्लेटफॉर्म इज फिक्स्ड परफेक्टली इनलास्टिक बोल रहे हो एंड द हाइट टू व्हिच इट राइजेस बोल रहे हो. आपने जीरो टाइप किया है. जीरो इज नॉट द आंसर. द प्रॉब्लम इज अ कैची प्रॉब्लम. थिंक केयरफुली एंड सो
सर. फाइंड द हाइट
टू व्हिच स्मॉल एम राइजेस आफ्टर द कोलिजन. प्लेटफॉर्म इज फिक्स्ड. Platform is fixed.
So we are releasing small m from that position, right?
Wonderful. Released from this horizontal position. And it will collide with the platform because h is lesser than.
Yes, sir.
एक मिनट सर. हो रहा है. People
are typing to the co-host. Please type to the host. Co-host is the cell phone. The message will flash and it will go. If I keep reading the messages here, the screen will get frozen.
तो भेजा आपको
think Shaurya, your answer is right, though I am unable to read it properly. नहीं Vinayak, no.
आपने किसका आंसर करेक्ट बोला?
Shaurya, S O U R.
सर वो मैं सर सौरभ ही बोल सर.
Wait, पूरा नाम नहीं देख पा रहा हूँ मैं. What's your name?
Sauradeep.
Sauradeep. Vinayak, मैंने height पूछा है. आप ऐसा quantities type करके जबरदस्ती मुझे फिर से type करके बोल रहे हो जो height है ही नहीं. Dimensionally height तो दे दो. mg l by 2 height होगा यार. Dimensions तो देख लो. ऊपर से जबरदस्ती दो दो बार टाइप करोगे मान लो यही आंसर. सुनो first of all the bob will come and strike here 90% should I wait? Okay I'll wait. It will be h to the power 5 by l to the power 4. H to the power 5 by l to the power 4 will be your answer. H to the power 5 by l to the power 4. Yeah. Now have a look at this. When this comes here, this will have a velocity of u in this direction. Do you all agree with that?
Yes.
What will be the value of u just before collision?
Root 2gh.
This will have a horizontal and vertical component.
Yes.
If I take this to be theta, 90 minus theta, this will be theta. This will be u sine theta and this will be u cos theta.
Yes,
remember,
sir.
When it is a perfectly inelastic collision, which velocity gets destroyed? U sin theta gets
normal
destroyed.
To the
u cos theta, per there is no force in the horizontal direction.
Yes,
it's
sir.
Yes, sir. It will not rise up. Why? U sin theta became zero. Why? Because it is perfectly inelastic collision. Elastic and inelastic components of velocity by velocity of separation by approach is along
normal.
Along this direction, relative velocity of separation is zero. Common tangent is not affecting your small e there. U cos theta will survive. U sin theta is dead. Is that clear?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
By virtue of U sin theta, the bob will compel here. Sorry, U cos theta. Just before the string becomes taut, its velocity was U cos theta. Just before the string becomes taut. Right? Just after the string becomes taut. If this is theta, this will be theta. If this is theta, this will be theta. This will be theta. U cos square theta will survive. U cos theta sine theta will get destroyed. If I have resolved them properly. This is theta. This will be theta. This will be theta. This velocity is perpendicular to the string. This velocity is parallel to the string. This velocity is dead because of what? The impulse in the string. Is this point very clear to all?
So,
because with U cos theta here, just before the string becomes taut, the blue color line is the velocity. Its velocity in this direction will be U cos square theta. Its velocity in this direction is U cos theta sine theta. Final velocity will be zero. V final along this length should be zero. Why should it be zero? Because this end is fixed. This end along the length of the string should have the same velocity. String constraints. So final velocity is zero. This is destroyed. So much change in momentum is happening due to which impulsive force?
Tension.
This will not be affected by this because it is perpendicular. So this will survive. With this velocity, it will rise up. Half m u cos square theta will be mg h dash. M and m will go. U will be under root 2gh divided by 2. Cos square theta. How much is cos theta? H by l. Cos theta is h by l. This will be g h dash. Square both sides. After squaring both sides.
When taken that yeah, v squared, we have to get the u cos square theta term squared. सर सीधा हम लोग काइनेमैटिक्स में इक्वेशन है ना वो यूज कर सकते
हैं एनर्जी कंजर्वेशन करने में कोई दिक्कत हाफ एम यू
सर नो
एन वी एच डैश एम एंड एम गेट्स कैंसिल्ड यू स्क्वायर कॉस टू द पावर 4 थीटा इज इक्वल टू 2 जी एच डैश यू स्क्वायर इज 2 जी एच कॉस थीटा इज एच बाय एल Hold to the power 4, 2g h dash, 2 and 2 will go, g and g will go. H dash is h to the power 5 by n to the power 4. Two important concepts in the problem. First, when I say perfectly inelastic collision, that is applicable along
common number.
The surface is smooth, common tangent ke direction mein velocities and momentum are. Unaffected. It will move till here. Here an impulsive force due to the string will come into life. Till the bob comes here, there is no tension in the string. This impulsive force will balance out this change in momentum. Only an impulsive force can balance out another impulsive force. This momentum will sustain, will survive because the impulsive force is perpendicular to that momentum.
We can't use kinematics in this side because string will remain taut.
हाँ सर वो नहीं यूज़ कर सकते.
Tension provides the centripetal force लेंगे फिर dynamic equation लेंगे लंबा पड़ेगा.
हाँ सर उसमें दो equation solve करना पड़ेगा.
Work done by the tension will be zero, so conservation of energy will be easier.
survey.
Yes, sir, done.
So one very simple question. On a horizontal table, you are having the top view. There is a string which is connected to two masses. Initial separation between them is L. Right? And this is given a velocity of V. This is kept on a horizontal table, smooth horizontal table. Smooth horizontal table, smooth horizontal table, right? A and B are connected by a string, right? Which is of length 2L. Length of the string is 2L. Length of string is 2L. No big deal till here. This is given a velocity of V. Right? Now what happens? This will not move initially. Till the string becomes taut, this will not move. This is moving straight this way. When the string becomes taut, find the velocity of both A and B. When the string becomes taut, find the velocity of both A and B. A and B. Write down the statement. When the string becomes taut, find the velocity of both A and B. When the string becomes taut, T-A-U-T, find the velocity of both A and B. Question is quite easy. Don't amplify your trouble, simplify your problem. Just before the string is taut, the velocity in these two directions is something that I'm interested in. Right, just before the string is taut, this will be V. I'll take this as theta, this will be V cos theta and V sin theta. When the string becomes taut, there will be T delta T acting in this direction. And this velocity will become V final. Ab tak to zero kar rahe the nahi yaar. Ab tak this point was fixed. So this was zero, this will become zero. Now this point is not fixed. It will also have the same velocity as V final. Along the length of the string, both the ends of the string should have the same velocity. Yes, till now, why were you making it zero? Till now, this point was fixed. Hence, I was making it zero. Now, this point is not fixed. Along the length of the string, both will have the same velocity. V sin theta will remain unaffected. Right? Now, listen carefully. If I am writing the equation only for this mass m, then it would be minus T delta T is equal to mv final minus mv cos theta. Agreed?
Yes.
Now, the same t delta t will act on this as well. T delta t and momentum are in the same direction. Mv final minus zero. If I add both of them, I will get mv cos theta is equal to m plus m into v final. Don't you think this is conservation of momentum of both the masses put together?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Writing for small m and small m separately, conserve momentum for both put together. What about the impulsive force here? It becomes an internal.
Yes, sir, internal. Mm-hmm.
Along the length of the string, you can conserve linear momentum directly and find V final. So V final will be m will get cancelled, v cos theta by 2. You know v is given, right? This b a particle's velocity, now velocity of a will be root over of this square plus this square. What is v final? V final is v cos theta by 2 whole square plus v sine theta whole square. And velocity of B will be only V final. V final is V cos theta by 2. And how do you get the value of cos theta? Not difficult. You know, this is 2L.
Yes, sir,
60 degrees.
Understood the logic? Why
yes, sir.
We would not prefer this. We would take both the particles into consideration and make this impulsive force an internal force so that I can conserve linear momentum in that particular direction.
Sir.
Huh?
Sir, can you please explain the first equation, like the minus t delta t?
Yes, m into v final momentum minus initial momentum. Both the momentums are in this direction. T delta t is in the opposite direction. So minus t delta t is m into v final minus m into v cos theta. Final momentum minus initial momentum.
Sir, so v cos theta is the velocity just before it gets taut, right?
Right. Just okay. Before the string is taut, v cos theta is the velocity along the length of the string.
Yes, sir. Okay, sir.
This angle I have taken as theta. So when you extend this line, this angle will be theta.
Yes, sir. So it will be 30.
60.
Sine theta will be half. I will leave it to your fine judgment what theta will be.
Yes.
So can you also explain the second equation, like t delta t is mvf minus 0.
T delta t is m into v final minus initial momentum is 0.
Oh yes, so
t is the change in momentum. So that is in this direction, m into v final is also in the same direction. It's nothing but f equal to ma. It's nothing but f equal to ma. This delta t, if I bring it to the denominator, this is ma.
So in the third equation, we could conserve momentum because t delta t became internal force, right?
Right. It is a sum of these two. I have done this with two masses, if you people remember. I took n delta t on this, n delta t on this.
Yes,
I wrote change in momentum for m1 and m2. Added both, I'll get conservation of momentum only for both put together. Can I run the board? This is a smooth wall. Inclined at an angle of theta. There is a body moving with a velocity v. Frictionless surface towards a smooth inclined wall as shown in the figure. The collision with the wall is perfectly elastic. Collision with wall is perfectly elastic. First question, impulse imparted by the wall on the sphere. J due to wall on sphere. J dash due to sphere.
It's a warning.
J dash due to sphere on the ground. Floor on
sir, collision with ground is perfect.
Floor only due to floor on sphere. It will be the same equal and opposite, but it's so.
Sir, with the ground, the collision is elastic or inelastic?
All elastic. Conserve the speed or the kinetic energy of the particle when it is coming back. Or instead, to avoid confusion, I'll say kinetic energy of the ball, collision with the wall and floor, kinetic energy of small m remains same after while coming back. While return. It's returning with the same speed. That's the bottom line. To avoid confusion. I am keen on something which you should see here. The question given is for a particular reason.
So J is the impulse, right?
J is the impulse. The problem has nothing in it. Only one particular point I want to highlight here. Impulsive force is balanced by only another.
Only impulsive force.
Now, why did you give this problem then? Have a look at it. When the ball comes over here, I'll draw the ball ahead now. When the ball comes over here, with red ink, the impulse will look good. This I am taking as J. This angle will be theta. So what will this be? J sine theta. The ball moves with a velocity V after collision. Mv minus of minus Mv. Agreed? J sine theta is in this direction. Final momentum is in that direction. Initial momentum was in the opposite direction. So minus of minus. This is 2Mv. So J will be equal to 2Mv by sine theta. Tell your students don't have a problem. The mistake which they commit is generally with this. Now what is J dash? Floor is exerting an impulse of J dash on this. So when you tell the kids that the ball doesn't bounce, it goes back with the same speed. What they do is they write J dash is equal to J cos theta plus mg. This will be a blunder. The question is given for that sake. Mg is not an impulsive force. Another impulsive force. The question is mainly given for students to realize that J dash will be balanced by J cos theta. If you know the value of J, you know J dash. J dash is 2mv by sine theta into cos theta.
Yes, sir.
Sir, why did we not resolve the velocity along the common normal?
Yes, sir.
And along the floor.
Yes, sir. You can, but then dono unchanged rahenge na, ek elastic ki wajah se and ek opposite direction.
Sir, but we'll get the impulse na. We'll get the impulse to be 2mv sine theta because of that.
Yes, sir.
I didn't get you.
Sir, if we resolve the velocity along the common normal and along the wall.
Velocity, it comes this way. Haan. Okay.
So V sin theta and V cos theta hoega. Along the wall, V cos theta and along.
Net total speed remains constant. Aap fir se uska resultant le lo. Root over of V square sin square theta plus V square cos square.
Nahin sir, to fir wo, kyunki agar impact ke wajah se jo impulse hoga, that will be only along the common normal na. क्योंकि एक कोलिजन में पब्लिक कोलिजन में आपने बोला था
हियर वी डिडंट गिव यू दैट स्कोप वी आर टेलिंग यू दैट इट इज गोइंग बैक विद द सेम स्पीड ऑप्शन दिया ही नहीं मैंने एलिमिनेट कर दिया टेक्निकली व्हाट यू से इज राइट फर्स्ट आई विल टेक इंपल्स हियर देन आई विल टेक इंपल्स हियर देन आई विल फाइंड आउट द न्यू वेलोसिटी वो ऑप्शन मैंने निकाल दिया बिकॉज़ आई वांट टू कंसंट्रेट ऑन समथिंग डिफरेंट
अच्छा तो इधर भी ओके ओके अंडरस्टूड
Sir, can you explain again why J dash is equal to J cos theta plus mg is wrong?
Impulsive forces alone can balance impulsive
forces. Impulsive force, yes.
Non-impulsive forces cannot balance an impulsive force.
Okay, sir. So, mg isn't an impulsive force like necessary.
Right.
Sir, but ideally, if we use that, the method which I was saying that V sin theta, V cos theta, usse bhi hum log eventually resolve karke same hi aana chahiye na, end mein, because elastic collision le rahe hain.
No, there you are finding out new velocity. There, because of this impulse, there will be a new velocity. I didn't give you that option that I eliminated.
Achha, haan, theek hai, samajh gaya. Okay, sir.
Can I rub the board?
Yes. Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Yes.
Now you will solve this. I'll give you time. This is theta. This is capital M. A smooth ball is dropped from a height of H. Smooth ball is dropped from a height of H. This is small m. Dropped from a height of H on a smooth and fixed incline. Incline is fixed right now. I'm making your life a bit simple. In another 10 minutes, the incline will not be fixed.
HCV mein tha aisa hi ek question.
Yes, right.
Sir, after collision, velocity of the ball is directed horizontally. After collision, velocity of the ball is directed horizontally. First question, find small e. After collision, velocity of the ball is directed horizontally. Find small e. Second question, if the collision is elastic, find the impulse on the ball. If the collision is elastic, find impulse on small. Right? Here, write down the statement, after collision, small m is directed horizontal. After collision, small m is directed horizontally. Will you try?
Yes, sir.
Sir, if, like, have they given us the velocity while going back?
No. That's why even when I wrote, I rubbed it immediately because you people will assume that velocity. Velocity after collision is not given.
Have so to find the E for elastic collision.
First bit may there is no elastic collision. Find small.
Okay, sir.
Second bit may if it is an elastic collision. So answer should be in terms of theta.
Yes, sir. Understood.
This is a very old Roorkee question. Yeah. Somewhere in 90s they asked this. For Doma, not a very tough one.
So are you checking the chat?
Small e is tan square theta.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir. It's quite simple. Have a look at this. Quite simple. What is the velocity with which it's striking?
2gh.
Under root 2gh. Let me call this V, let me call that U. This will be theta. Small e will be equal to, this is theta, this is theta, this is 90 minus theta. V, if it is moving after collision with the velocity V, V cos 90 minus theta will become V sine theta.
Yes.
Cos theta. Right? V sine theta minus velocity of the wedge upon U cos theta. Small e is along the common normal. Right? Now, V is also not given, U is also not given, but you know that along the common tangent, velocity before and after collision will be the same.
Yes.
Yes, sir.
So this is mu. This will be mu sine theta, momentum along the common tangent before collision. Momentum along the common tangent after collision will be mv cos theta. Right? So sine theta by cos theta will be equal to v by u. V by u, sine theta cos
tan square.
Tan square theta will be small. All that you have done is calculated small e along common normal and along the common tangent you equated the momentum. Now, last year one student asked me, sir, along the common tangent there is an external force called gravity.
Non-impulsive.
At that instant, just before and just after collision, limit delta t tends to zero. Only impulsive forces can create a change in momentum. Non-impulsive forces cannot change momentum in a short time interval. Right? In that short time interval, momentum along the inclined plane will remain conserved for smaller. Second bit, what will J look like? This is the inclined plane. This is J. Along the common normal, J will be mv sine theta, final momentum, minus of minus mu cos theta. Right? Final momentum, initial momentum along the common normal. Can you substitute the relation U is under root 2gh and you know V now? You know the value of V. Have a look at it. Instead of sine theta by cos theta, replace sine theta by cos theta by V. E is equal to V square by U square. So V square is equal to E U square. E 2gh with a square root is V. Can I substitute this V here? You know the value of U. And sine theta, cos theta, you leave the answer in terms of theta because theta is given. Or make it more simple, V sine theta is E cos theta. M into V sine theta is E U cos theta plus mu cos theta. And E is equal to 1. 2 times mu cos theta will be your answer.
Sin theta is pi by 4.
इधर theta को eliminate करना पड़ेगा ना.
Theta is not given in the question. You will get the
answer. But we know now. Tan square theta. Theta pi by. Tan square theta 1.
Right. Tan square theta is 1 for the second bit. Yeah. Tell me when I can rub the board.
They're done.
So 1 minute.
Sir, can you repeat how you got E is V squared by U squared?
Sin theta by cos theta is V by U.
Oh, yes, sir.
But yet I didn't use that. That will be lengthier. Instead of V sin theta is U cos theta. V sin theta is V U cos theta. Yes or no?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Makes the simplification easier.
Sir, one moment, sir. Yes, sir, done.
No, listen, this is a slightly tougher problem. I'll give you 5-10 minutes to solve and no hurry. This ball is A and there is a ball B. Falling this way such that the ball B is touching the string. A ball A is suspended by an inextensible length of a string of length L is equal to 1.5 meters. Suspended from the point O. Another identical ball, A and B are identical. A and B are identical. A and B are identical. Is dropped vertically downwards such that its surface remains just in contact with the thread. B remains just in contact with the thread. B remains just in contact with the thread. B remains just in contact with the thread. During downward motion and collides elastically with the suspended ball. If the suspended ball just completes a vertical circle after collision, A just completes a vertical circle. For a body to complete a vertical circle, what should its velocity be?
Root 5 g.
Under root?
5
g. The velocity of the falling body just before collision. Find velocity of B just before collision. Just before collision.
Sir.
Take G as 10 meter per second square.
Sir, does B start from the start of the string?
We don't know. The velocity. If I tell you it is dropped from here, the question doesn't.
The root 2 G. Yes. Okay, ho jayega.
Collision is under root 2 G.
Yes.
Sir, so asking you velocity with which B strikes A, so that A after collision completes a vertical circle. It's an elastic collision. Collision between B and A is elastic. Did I not write that?
You told that.
After elastic collision. After an elastic collision, the collision between B and A is elastic. I also don't remember the answer. 12.5 meters per second here.
Sir, it is coming out to be 1.25.
No, sir. Could
वो
be
शायद आपने 15 meter होगा sir फिर.
I'll solve. No issue, wait.
जो उसने बोला वो ही आता है. उसने जो बोला 12.5 नहीं था.
1.25 या 12.5?
1.25.
One.
Thank you. this geometry which I have drawn here, is it clear to all?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
This angle is theta. See, this is the center of this sphere. This is the center of the sphere. This distance will be to R?
Yes, sir.
Yes.
This distance is R. Sine theta is R?
Yes, sir.
So, if this angle is theta, this angle is theta. Right?
Yes,
so, just sir. Before collision, this is the situation and theta is 30 degrees. Just after collision, what will be the situation? This will remain V naught sine theta. This will not change. This I will call it as Vn. This I will call it as V. This I will call it as V. No. This V is under root 5GL. Hence, I'm interested in that particular value. Right. This 5GL ka, this component, I wish I'm taking theta properly. This was theta, right? So this will be theta. This will be under root 5GL cos theta. This will be under root 5GL sine theta. I know the resultant velocity in that direction is under root 5GL. It's cos theta component, sine theta component. Now here, one student asked me long back, they're identical masses. Perfectly elastic collision. Interchangeable
velocity. Change the velocity.
You cannot. There is another impulsive force T delta T here. Two bodies, when they collide, when there is no other external force on them, if they are identical and elastic collision will interchange their velocities. T delta T comes into the picture. Don't interchange their velocities. There is an impulsive force.
Yes.
Right?
Yes.
Now your first equation. This velocity remains the same, no issue. Small e will be equal to Vn under root 5GL sine theta minus of minus Vn upon V naught cos theta minus 0. See if you are convinced with this equation. This velocity minus this velocity upon initial velocity of this minus initial velocity. V2 minus V1 upon U1 minus U2, but along common normal. Along common normal, put this equal to 1. This is my first equation. Theta value is known to me. Vn is a variable. V0 is a variable. He asked you for V0. Theta value is known to me. Vn is one variable. Velocity along the normal direction of the ball after collision. And V0 is what has been asked. If I can eliminate Vn, don't you think my job is done?
Yes.
Now, in these cases, agreed, along tangential direction, I have already taken V0 sin theta. We know I already equated the momentum. In the horizontal direction for whole of the system. For whole of the system, horizontal to the ground, is there any impulsive momentum. Force? Is there any impulsive force?
No, sir. Many.
Right? Now listen. M into under root 5GL is the final momentum of small m. Minus, take these values properly, theta, if this is theta, this is theta, this is theta, am I right?
Yes,
yes, sir.
Minus m vn sine theta plus m v naught sine theta cos theta. I resolved Vn along this direction, V0 sin theta along this direction. That's the final momentum of the system in the horizontal direction. Do you agree with that?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Initial momentum in the horizontal direction is zero. Initial momentum in the horizontal direction, this bob is falling vertically. Initial momentum is zero. So technically, M will go under root 5GL is equal to Vn sin theta plus V naught sin theta cos theta. Two equations and two variables. To my knowledge, should not be difficult for you. What did he ask you? He asked for V naught. Eliminate Vn. Calculate Vn from here and substitute. Theta is 30 degrees. Isse acha trigonometric function kahan milega?
Sir, shouldn't Vn also be equal to V naught cos theta only? Because elastic collision.
So you're interchanging the velocities?
No, sir, I'm not interchanging the velocity, but V sin theta uska common rahega. But
on this, are you getting Vn equal to V naught cos
theta? No, sir, not. I didn't use that. I was thinking
you
whether.
You have to use this. Small e is along the common normal.
Yes,
this sir. Velocity minus of minus this velocity upon V naught cos theta minus V. This has a velocity component in this direction. Iska component
yes, direct. Sir. Ye hai samjha. My question was why isn't Vn also equal to V naught cos theta? Because in aisa elastic collision hai na, to along common normal, the
velocity
will be equal along the common normal after.
But pura system ka common normal ke hisab se to equal hi hai na.
Ek baar bol chuka hu, sun nahi rahe ho yaar. This interchanging of velocity small e, interchanging of velocity will happen only if there is no other
external force. He's saying the magnitude along the common.
How will it be same? T sin T delta T will act no here. In this direction, T delta T ka component hai ki nahi?
Haan sir, haan hoga ek along V.
So, you cannot.
Are you going to run it, John?
So second equation is conservation of momentum along horizontal direction, right?
For whole of the system.
Yeah, okay.
Not just for one mass. Ek mass ka momentum conserve nahi ho raha. Pura system ka line se, there's only vertical force. T delta T impulsive. Non-impulsive gravity, all in the vertical direction. Horizontal direction for whole of the system, there is no external force. So you conserve okay. Linear momentum.
Okay, sir.
होमवर्क एचसीवी का दिया हुआ है मैंने
दिया हुआ है बहुत सारा
होमवर्क कंप्लीट एचसीवी एक्सेप्ट द चेन प्रॉब्लम चेन ड्रॉपिंग 51st प्रॉब्लम है वो
इट वाज इवन देयर इन डब्ल्यूपी का बुकलेट
हां सर था
नो This concept is different. It is an impulsive force and that too inelastic. Chain problem dropping. Number bataunga.
57. 8 seconds.
प्रॉब्लम एक छोड़ के कंप्लीट एचसीवी एक्सेप्ट 57 बुकलेट एक्सरसाइज 1 कंप्लीट एक्सेप्ट क्वेश्चन नंबर 48 एक्सरसाइज 1 ऑफ द बुकलेट में कौन सा क्वेश्चन पेंडिंग रखोगे
48
एचसीवी में
57
वी विल टेक अनदर 4 एंड हाफ टू 5 लेक्चर्स टू कंप्लीट कंजर्वेशन ऑफ मोमेंटम डोंट बी अंडर द इंप्रेशन दैट इट्स ओवर देयर इज लॉट मोर टू बी डन राइट
यस सर
You will receive assignment as soon as you complete booklet exercise 1. Technically, you can solve even exercise 2. Why should I keep exercise 2 pending? Not required. Exercise 2 can be done. Except for one or two very tough ones. Ninth problem will be a bit tough, but you can attempt. Flagship batch, itna to we should trouble you. एक सेकंड रुको बनाजा ऑफर हाँ वेरी गुड
सर न्यू ईयर है सर
हाँ इसीलिए तो दे रहा हूँ एक्सरसाइज
न्यू ईयर गिफ्ट है
एक्सरसाइज 1 2
सर इतने नहीं सर काफी
सर न्यू ईयर है
एक्सरसाइज 2
बट वी हैव अ टेस्ट
नो बार्गेन
सर कब पर सर ये तो आप बोल रहे हो ना ये अब बाकी टीचर्स न्यू ईयर की छुट्टी के नाम पे सर क्या देंगे
चल रहे सर
नो लास्ट
200 सम्स का सर
होमवर्क सिर्फ एचसीवी दिया है
यस
सर
वीक रिलैक्स हुआ
है नहीं
सर
सर बदला मत निकालो
फ्लैगशिप बैच है इतना तो मेहनत करना
सर बट वी आर आल्सो
करना खत्म हो गया आपके लिए नाउ व्हाट कम्स इनटू इज ओनली एक्सरसाइज 1 2 एंड 3 2 एंड 3 आर स्मॉल कोशिश करो राइट
सर डिफिकल्ट होंगे
कब तक इट डिपेंड्स ऑन यू पीपल आई हैव पेंडिंग डाउट्स डिस्कशन ऑफ एचसीवी राइट एचसीवी डाउट्स डिस्कशन किया है दिस इंटेंशनली आई एम नॉट डूइंग बिकॉज़ आई हैव ओनली वन लेक्चर विद यू पीपल
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Saturday को छुट्टी
सुनो next week भी seniors का crash course का pressure है तो आपके लिए थोड़ा कम lecture ही मिलेगा seniors का crash course we should finish by Jan 15 so Jan first week थोड़ा pressure रहेगा so next week I'll take up the doubts of HCV first I'll not take up exercise 1, 2, 3 so you have time मगर don't keep it pending drops of water makes an ocean हर दिन 10 questions कर लो खत्म हो जाए फेयर इनफ
यस
यस सर
सर क्रैश कोर्स क्यों होता
है हेलो सर
हां पहले थैंक्स बोलो
थैंक यू सर
हैप्पी न्यू ईयर बोलो
हैप्पी न्यू ईयर सर
नाइट क्लास की पूछा
पड़ा 31st को क्लास
न्यू ईयर को नाइट क्लास
सर नाइट होमवर्क
हो जाएगा सर नाइट क्लास
प्रायोरिटी टू देम Next year will be your time. Don't.
Hello, sir.
Bolo.
Sir, can you repeat how you got the second equation in this problem?
Second equation, conservation of momentum in the horizontal direction for whole of the system.
Yes, I got. There is no this force. Momentum,
minus this momentum. A dono velocity is the direction we resolve kiya hai. Initial momentum is zero.
Yes, sir.
Sir, can you explain the point ki impulsive force is only balanced by another impulsive force?
Repeat that 5 times and remember it. Point kya usme kya explain chahiye? Non-impulsive force short time interval mein cannot generate substantial change in momentum. Only impulsive force in that short time interval can generate substantial change in momentum. So non-impulsive forces do not balance an impulsive force.
Sir. Sir, yesterday on WhatsApp, I sent you one problem, sir.
Next 15 days, tak kuch mat bhejo.
Okay.
We are seniors' doubts. 15 din unke liye de do. Uske baad aapka doubts le.
Okay, sir.
Jan 15th ke baad, your seniors will be busy with their college prelims. So then whole of the time will give you.
Sir, first attempt kabhi phir abhi unka?
मार्च में बोल रहे हैं ऐसा हो
सकता
है टुडेस न्यूज सेज मार्च विल बी डिफिकल्ट बिकॉज़ ऑफ इलेक्शंस इन सम स्टेट्स इट विल बी इन द मंथ ऑफ अप्रैल
गुड सर फर्स्ट अटेम्प्ट
एडवांस्ड ऑर्बिट डिले
हां हां मेरी
बहुत डिले हुआ फिर तो
मतलब सो व्हेन विल यू ऑल स्टार्ट ऑफलाइन
हां सर ऑफलाइन
सर वैसे लगेगा
अभी ऑफ दिस वीक दे आर वेटिंग फॉर सिग्नल गवर्नमेंट वांट टू से समथिंग अबाउट ओमिक्रॉन This week ka they'll see, but offline, nearby future, it is very difficult because BMC is continuously insisting only one student per bench.
Sir, please. Sir, but after we get vaccinated.
Vaccination third se chalu ho raha.
Right. Wish you all a happy new year.
Sir,
happy new year.
Happy new year,
sir.